Do you frequently have to review master data sets? If so, then we've got good news for you. The Master Data Workbook dialogues in the SAP IBP add-in for Microsoft Excel have been enhanced. So, what's new? Let's take a closer look. On the left-hand side, there's the new Workbook filter. The Workbook filter can be used to apply filters across multiple sheets. We'll come back to this feature in a minute. Next to the Workbook filter section, there's the tab bar, which allows you to navigate across the General, Attributes, and Filter tabs. Which tabs are available depends on the selected worksheet type. You can choose between Master Data and Planning Objects. Let's start with the Master Data worksheet type and select a different Master Data type. The information text beneath the version selection indicates whether you're authorized to edit the entries of the selected master data type. If you have the required permissions, you're automatically in edit mode. The edit checkbox has been removed from the dialog. Next, we navigate to the Attributes tab. Here you can find all the attributes that are assigned to the selected master data type. By default, all attributes are selected, but you can remove the attributes that you don't want to be displayed and reorder the attributes as you like. Now, let's navigate to the Filter tab. Before we make a change in the worksheet filter, let's take another look at the Workbook filter. We'll add two filters. On the right-hand side, you may have noticed that the Customer ID filter has appeared. If a Workbook filter doesn't show up on the Filter tab, it can't be applied for the selected master data type, as there's no relation between the attribute and the master data type. If you want to consider filters for attributes that aren't part of the selected master data type, select the Advanced filtering mode. The Common Filter checkbox has been removed from the top of the dialog, and the function has been replaced by the Workbook filter in combination with the Advanced filtering mode. With the help of the Advanced filter, you could apply the Product Group filter to the Customer Product Master Data type. For now, we'll stick to the simple filtering mode. Now we'll add a new worksheet, and this time we select the worksheet type Planning Objects. What if you don't know the planning level description, only the key figure? Click on the ellipsis button next to the planning level dropdown, and the system will help you identify the right planning level. We'll leave the predefined values for version, week, and rolling as they are. The information text in blue indicates whether you will be able to edit planning objects of the selected planning level. On the Key Figures tab, you can select the key figures that you're interested in. We've defined all the necessary settings and we're now ready to view the data. To do so, choose OK and the Master Data Workbook opens. Now you can review the data. There are plans to further improve the Master Data Workbook features, so stay tuned and join the What's New webinars.